watching out. 20.
I think we'll make a start to the proceedings. Good evening, everybody. Welcome along to our 10th annual Duke of Edinburgh Awards evening. This is a really, really big evening for us. 10th year at the Academy. We've had another fantastic year of students going through and achieving their awards. And tonight is even a more significant night. In our 10th year, we have got over 500 students through their Duke of Edinburgh Award in 10 years. So I think that deserves a round of applause. And just to get a flavour of what that looks like, we just got a bit of a video to show you.
Thank you.
hopefully you all got to see a glimpse of yourself somewhere along there. There seems to have been lots of tears and mud and sunshine and wet days as DAV holds in store for us. Can I just welcome along tonight as well, we have the Mayor, John Fox, who's going to help us present the certificates later. We've got our Board of Governors that are supporting us. We have a head teacher, Mr. Jeff Walls, and we have our guest speaker tonight, Mr. Steve Cook, who's going to say a few words later on. I just wanted to just talk a little bit quickly about the award. We've achieved over 500 students have we've managed to get through their awards. This year we're just a little bit down on our pass rate, but not far off. I know that we have about 12 students who are pending this year that are sitting with Peterborough at head office waiting to be approved. And that shows you that it's just not myself or Mr. Turner or the school that are approving. They do go to the LEA in Peterborough and they verify what you do. And that just keeps the award at the strength that it is and that nobody slips through the net, that we validate everything that you do. We know who you volunteer with, etc. So yeah, we've got 88 through. We've got 6 students who completed their gold. This year we had Mrs. German. Where's Mrs. German? Mrs. German had her little finger out at St. James's Palace this year, meeting royalty and supporting some of her gold students receiving their awards. We have 28 students who completed their silver. And their biggest number to date we've had on a bronze. We have 54 students who've got 3 bronze, so that's fantastic this year. Brilliant. Expeditions from Rutland to Morocco, it's been quite a year. Lots of different challenges, but another fantastic year with that. And the thing that I just wanted to talk to people about tonight is about the volunteering. It's that bit where you students give that little bit extra towards the school community, the local community, and I had a quick look through what sort of things you've been doing for your volunteering, and it's been amazing. The support that you give to other teachers in school, whether it be being a maths mentor or whether it be a reading buddy, those skills that you're learning along the way are priceless. And one of the things that I wanted to talk to you about tonight was about, on to the next slide, sir. One of the things I wanted to talk to you about tonight was about how you can use that stuff. How can you make it useful when you move on into your next stage of either being in education or going for a job or whatever that may be. There is a way that employers are looking for something extra. I mean, Mr. Walls will probably be looking at me here when I say academia is not important. Of course it's important, but it's the other things that you do along the way that makes you that more rounded person. You can see the things that you've all been getting up to. And on the next slide there is just some stuff that, how I think that you can best use your award in the future. You know, to volunteer is to be a team player. You've gone and sought this. You've gone and found out what you wanted to do. The award is about you as a person and what you want to achieve from it. And the skills you get along the way, being a team player, that is what the workforce are looking for. When employees choose a member of staff, they're looking at more than just their qualifications. They want a team player. They want someone who they don't have to look over the shoulder all the time. They want a problem solver. Someone who has a positive attitude towards things. That when things get a little bit tough, you can dig a little bit deeper and you can show resolve to get through it. Whether that be with your academic and your qualifications or whether that be in other phases of your life as you grow older. Customer service, you will have been dealing with people that you think, that hasn't been good or I didn't enjoy that, but you've experienced that and that will stand you in good stead as you go into the future. And to self-manage, and that's what your boss is looking for. That initiative, that get up and go, that problem solving, all of those kind of things that you can talk about when you do sit in an interview, whether it be for a part-time job, your next stage of your education, university, employment. And I know the Duke of Edinburgh is endorsed by multinational companies across the globe, and they recognise it. And as soon as you sit down in an interview and you can talk about your Duke of Edinburgh award and the experiences that you have, you know, you're going to the top of the pile. You know, you're going to the next stage of that interview, for sure you are. So don't forget to use these experiences along the way. They are invaluable. invited us. So yeah, please do that for me. Okay, can I ask our guest speaker to come up and have a few words?
Good evening. This is a fantastic privilege to be, for me, to be honest with you, to get the opportunity to meet a whole bunch of highly talented and clearly very motivated young people. My name's Steve Cook. I've had a long corporate career, and I've worked around the world. I know the UK, I know Australia, New Zealand, South Africa. I've worked in continental Europe, so I'm reasonably well qualified to know how employers value the D of E experience and the whole D of E culture. I don't know whether you know, but the D of E is actually up and running, practiced, available, I'm not sure what the right word is, in 141 countries. Which sounds like quite a lot to me. I know there's 193 nations, I think, that make up the United Nations. So to have the D of E available in 141 seems like quite a lot. And I did read that in 2016, like last year, around the world there were something like 1.2 million participants. So you're part of a big universe of people, young people, doing this. And I think the point I would make about what employers are looking for, I mean, we're talking here about the challenge, really, of getting, you know, an entry-level job, getting your foot on the ladder, starting off in the workplace, you know, quite a challenging thing to do. I mean, these days, it's certainly not straightforward, and young people have got qualifications coming out of their ears compared to what life was like when I came out of school, which... it was a long time ago now. And employers, what they're after, above all else, is differentiation. You know, what's going to make you different from the 150 or 200 other people that have applied for this job? And you can take out of the DLE clearly initiative, motivation, being able to work in a team, and all those things, and Callum's already said that, so I don't want to people that, but I mean, the reality of life is that the DME is a demonstrable proof that you can do that. And I think, you know, determination and the will to get something done, you know, I can kind of relate to that a little bit myself, because, you know, in the more recent past, I encountered a bit of a problem back in 2012, which isn't that long ago, when I had serious heart problems. And I had to have a triple bypass operation, which sounded fairly horrific to me at the time, but I was sort of reassured by the surgeon that it was a perfectly normal standard procedure. You know, triple bypass didn't sound like a normal standard procedure to me, but in the end it turned out to be. And so since then, I've taken it upon myself to do challenging things. I'm working my way through what's known as the World Marathon Majors. So far I've been able to do Paris, Berlin, New York, and London. I'm doing the Tokyo Marathon at the end of February, and then I've got Boston left to do. I've also taken up a sport called duathlon, which is a run-bike-run format. And so, you know, what's that got in common with the D of E, you might say? Well, the fact of the matter is, you can't do these things unless you want to do them. And, you know, the photographs and that video that came up early on there, you know, spending a weekend up in the Peak District when it's lashing down and, you know, with a 25 mile an hour, or probably up there, 50 mile an hour winds, you know, there's, I'm sure all of you have been through that point where you think to yourself, what are we doing this for, right? And at the 20 mile mark in a marathon, I can tell you, that's exactly what you think every time. And people say to me, sometimes they say, well, do you enjoy it? actually quite a difficult question to answer, really, because it's painful. But when you've done it, you've done it. And you think to yourself, well, you know, that's pretty good. Not everybody can do that. And I think, you know, you come out of these D of E things and you must feel in yourselves that you've actually achieved something. And I think that's a very valuable thing to be able to tuck away and again bring out when you've got your you know, your first interview and so on and so forth, and you know, the person who's interviewing you says, well, you know, what else do you do apart from study? You can actually tell them, I've achieved something. You know, we do things, and everybody knows what that's all about. So congratulations to all of you. You're part of a very big universe. As I said, 1.2 million people around the world did this last year. And so you all deserve a huge, great round of applause. And I'd be very pleased to help hand out your mementos. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. Just goes to show you what you can achieve when faced with adversity, that you can find the inner strength to take on the next challenges and keep moving forward. Mayor, would you like to come and say a few words? We're playing hot seats at the front because every time someone gets up, I've got a seat.
Thank you. It's a great honour and privilege to be here tonight. And those who don't know anything about me, I left home at 15 and joined the Royal Navy. So I know what it's like because they sent me to a place near Ipswich in the middle of nowhere. And I know what it's like to be wet, damp, cold, hungry and tired because I went through what you went through. Probably a little bit more actually, but what you've done though is achieved it on your own merits, and that's something you want to be proud of, because I look back over the year that I was in basic training and I've got fond memories of all the camaraderie there was, all the absolute friendship you made with one another. It's a team building exercise, and you know, you're going to remember this for the rest of your life, and you deserve to, because you've done it on your own merits. Nobody did it for you. It's not like doing an exam. I'm not saying any of you cheat for exams, but you know what I'm saying. You've done this on your own merit because it takes your absolute strength of character to get through it. So I take the hats off to each and every one of you and say well done to you all. And I think all the parents should be very, very proud of your siblings, because it's not easy. I know from experience. So well done to each and every one of you.
We're going to start with the bronze awards. So, as your name is called out, okay, let's start off. This is the Bronze Awards. Can we have Yuki Honig, please? Amit Kute. Simran Bisla. Philippe Morosky. Hayden Paul. Oscar Woodbeat Mills. Joshua Campbell. Ewan Handley. Zoe Newson. Callum Dalladay. Rikwa Hussein. Patrick. Ahad Ahmed. Aman Ayaz. Ellen Carter. Ikra Shaheen. Maranisa Kunwal. Maria Mustafa. Maliha Khalil. Shireen Amin. Arian Zanelli. Owen Dalladay. Nabira Khan. Gabriella Rudnick. Leon Preston. Callum McGillery. Georgie Chappell. Medea Ahmed. Rizwana Hay. Akim Saran. Daniel Beaker. Zahar Shaki. Francesca Forden. Lina Mahmoud. Tony Chen. Alexander Meddings. Charlotte Davidson. Wallace Elson. Nabil Muntazin. Ah. Adam Ungar. Christopher Kazlukas. And Will Meddings. And that's all the bronze awardees. A big round of applause. Well done. If I would just like to say a few more words, just.
Yeah, all you that won the bronze award, well done. Absolutely fantastic achievement. Don't forget your silver and your gold. Go for it, I'm serious, go for it, because they make a big difference. And if you enjoyed the bronze, you've got no reason not to go for it, so go for it. All right? Well done.
Mr. Walls? Okay, we're moving on to silver. Poppy Richardson. Harriet Coulson. Baraz Pate. Gunraj Singh. Louisa Lake. Leon Kiss Chandler. Alima Ayaz. Gina Dealey. Ryan Danaher. Molly Hudson. Mohammed Hussein. Robbie Marcellia. And last but not least, Charlotte Hammond. Okay, and that concludes the silvers. Well done, all the silvers. Thank you. I'm just going to hand over to Mr. Walls, who's got a few words to say, and then we've got one last little thing to do after that.
Thank you. I've just been thinking, as I've been sat there, about the importance of this evening, not only for TDA, but really significantly for every single student that's been involved. And if you'll bear with me, I just want to talk about five things, but only 1 minute each. Okay? First is the success that this represents. And that has to be captured, not only in your mind, but it has to be celebrated. And if you think about what we've done this evening, we've very much reflected on what success means outside of GCSEs, A-levels, the wider development and success that this represents is absolutely, fundamentally important to your development as people. You are successful individuals. It also springs to mind as I look around and see the parents and the staff that you have had great support. And that is really important too. And I want to thank the parents for, I don't know, what is it, washing muddy clothes, dealing with the tears, getting the voluntary hours sorted, all of the support that you've given to your children in making this happen. I want to thank the staff for their support. This doesn't happen without a team of dedicated staff who care passionately about the development of young people. Thank you for your support. But thank you as well for the support that you have developed between you as young people. Don't lose that. Build on it. Continue to make it last and matter. How am I doing for minutes? What's my next S? Skills. Think of the skills that are represented in the activities that you've done to get this accreditation. You are becoming not only successful in your listening, but skillful in the way in which you can apply your learning to challenging situations. You are developing teamwork, resilience, all the skills that are required for modern life. Fantastic. We've talked about service, 4S. You have served the community through your actions. And those voluntary hours are fundamentally important. You have demonstrated that this is not just about yourself, but investing in others, serving the community. And the last one, I want to pose a challenge similar to Mr. Mayor. And I want you to stretch further. So those people that have achieved bronze, set your sights on silver. Silver, set your sights on gold. And gold, set your sights on the next challenge. You know what you need to do to stretch yourself further. Why is that important? Because we've heard from our guest speaker this evening that these are the things that mark us out as individuals. They make us distinctive. They make us who we are. And I want to challenge you. Stretch yourselves further. 5 S's. I won't repeat them because I've forgotten them already. Congratulations to all of you. And thank you very much for attending this evening. This is a highlight in the TDA year. And I want to thank you again for the organisers, for the special guests, but also for your attendance and concentration. Thank you.
Okay, that nearly concludes our evening. As you may have picked up on something that I said at the very start of the evening, we have, since we've started a TDA running Duke of Air back in 2007, this year we have had our, I think it's 522 we've got through, but somebody sitting in here tonight is our 500th person. And we thought to ourselves, well, we just cannot let that go past. When we added up all the figures and we looked at who that 500th person was, it was Alima Ayaz. Can you come down, please? Well done. Thank you. Well done. So not only do you get a challenge, I've got a challenge for another 500 to get through. So yeah, bring it on. That's what we want. We want more of it. Okay. So yeah, thank you very much indeed. Thanks for everybody for coming along. We just have one last little video clip for you to watch, and that's us done. Please, parents, keep them at their awards and make sure we get them through it. Thank you for this evening. Achilles.
and his gold, Achilles and his gifts, Spider-Man's control, combat with his fears. And clearly I will see myself in